vlog starting.
Wow.
Hello, TJ. How you doing?
All them players be arriving.
What do I even say in the beginning?
It's a new year, 2020. It's a new year, 2024. Vineland Poker League. It's week one. It's a regular poker tournament. 30,000 chips. Welcome back to the Vineland Poker League.
Hi, Vlog.
Hi, Vlog.
Texas Dolly Brunson, who wrote the book.
This is gonna be the best day. He's moving in for the kill.
And there it is. Helmuth wins the championship.
Moneymaker puts his name amongst the greatest players in the game.
Wake me now.
Greg Merson is the main event champion.
Biggest day of my life.
I want to start out with our championship belt from last year. You got this with Dave Lowery. Come on up, Dave. You guys are wearing the whole day.
That's pretty nice.
Who cares?
Weird. That's perfect.
Let me go over a few things real quick. So we can get started.
All right, I'm actually going to stop Jeremy right there for a second. So if you're new here, or if you're still confused about the specifics, let me quickly explain everything for you, starting with the history and past winners of this league. The Vineland Poker League has been running since 2008. From 2008 to 2021, the league would send its best player to the WSOP main event for a chance at glory, fame, and millions. But from 2022 on, we decided to up the stakes and send the best three players. I started this vlog in 2022 because I thought it would be so cool to capture the action now that we're sending three people instead of one. Unfortunately, the past winners of the league haven't done so well in the WSOP main event. In fact, Dave L broke the curse last year, cashing the main in 1,351st place for 15 grand. Before that, no previous winners had cashed in Vegas. Which brings us to this year. The Vineland Poker League in 2024 has 41 players. We play 12 tournaments, and after it's all said and done, the top three players with the most points will be awarded with a $10,000 WSOP main event buy-in. So how do you get points? How do you win? Well, we have a point system. For outlasting a player, you gain 3 points. For knocking another player out, you gain 1 point. And for winning one of the 12 tournaments, you gain an additional 10 points. If you have a bad finish, that's okay, because out of the 12 tournaments, only your top 10 scores count towards your year-end total. Which brings us to the keys to a seat, the keys to winning. They are final table as often as possible. Every point counts, and a final table is worth at least 90 points. In 2023, the top 4 players final tabled 6 or 7 times out of the 12, and the other 36 players final tabled 5 times or less. Next, knock out as many players as possible. As I said, every point counts and you'll receive 1 point for every person you knock out. And number 3, you can take some risks early on in the tournament, but if things don't go your way, be careful. You can only drop your 2 lowest scores. Take last year's results for example. This shows the top 13 players. A green score is a final table and a red score is a win. You see a lot of green and red towards the top of the leaderboard. When it comes to the middle of the pack, there's still a good amount of color here, especially red. Tim, Caitlin, and Andrew just didn't follow up their wins with many other good scores. And then it comes to the bottom of the leaderboard. Well, there's not much green or red here. Final tabling many times is the key to winning. All right, hope that helps. Back to Jeremy.
The blinds and Andy's are a little different this year. Not a whole lot, but a little bit. From here on out, we will start at 1 o'clock. For those who don't know, we send 3 people, just like last year. One thing I want to stress, especially for the new people, I run a pretty relaxed league, all right? I want everybody to get along and have a good time. I love and enjoy this game. I want to play every Sunday and enjoy myself. I don't want to argue with people, so I don't deal with bullshit. If there's an issue, please try to settle it yourself. Okay, if you can't, we have a couple floor guys. We got Bruce over here, Rob, and Spider. And finally, I just like to thank Tony and 5 Points for letting us play here this year and every past few years.
Okay, the first seating assignment this year. Since we have 41 players this year instead of 40 like last year, I guess the computer's confused and keeps toggling names back and forth, but it looks like we're on table 3 with Jesse and Tom, who finished really well last year, Tony D, Dave P, and Doc, who finished in the middle of the pack, Jason W, who watches these videos, and I got him into the league because of my vlog, which is cool, and Caitlin, Nixie, and Joe, who finished towards the bottom last year. Now let's take it to some week one action. Okay, let's start off week one with a banger. At 100-200 blinds, I opened a 400 in early position with pocket kings. Nick C calls in the cutoff, Tony D calls in the big blind, and we go 3 ways to a flop. That flop comes 6-5-3 all diamonds. Not the best flop for us, because we don't have the king of diamonds, but we still have a huge overpair to the board. We all check, and Nick deals the 6 of spades on the turn, pairing the board. Tony checks, and I announce a bet.
Yellow chipper, 1,000. Nick calls. Tony calls.
The river is a card you won't believe. The king of diamonds. Tony checks, and I announce an odd bet of 4375. I tell Nick if he raises, he'll be my best friend, and then he becomes my best friend and raises to 10,000. Tony gets out of the way, and I have to think about how I can get the max here.
I'm all in.
Nick calls and shows the ace of diamonds and the king of spades for the nut flush. That's no good, sir.
Sorry.
Hey. You don't have to be like that.
What happened? Yeah, you're right.
We double up early on in the tournament, and we have a massive stack now.
DJ, Jesus Christ. Lucky card.
The most amazing card that had to hit, fucking hit.
Bang, and we're off to an insane start in week one. We're double starting stack. We have a bunch of chips. Let's get some more.
Yeah.
Okay, so it isn't exactly pocket kings, but I'd consider this an above average hand. At 200-400 blinds, Jesse limped in early position and it folds to me. So I make it 1175 with my jack king off. Doc calls in the big blind, Jesse calls also, and we go three ways to a flop. Caitlin deals the ace king 6, 2 club flop, and Doc checks. Jesse has other plans and bets 2,000. With this hand on this board against these players, I might not necessarily be ahead, but I have enough chips to see another card. So I call and Doc calls as well. And good thing we kept fishing there, because we caught a jack of spades on the turn, giving us two pair. We all quickly check, and a pretty bad 10 of clubs hits the river. Both flush and straight draws came in now. Doc checks, Jesse checks, and I opt to just check behind.
Two pair.
My two pair is good. How nice was that, Jesse?
Very nice.
At 300-600 blinds, it folds to Jesse in middle position, and he raises to 1,500. It folds to Dave P. on the button, who calls. I call in the small blind with pocket fours, and Caitlin comes along with us in the big blind. Dave puts the 3 of clubs, 9 of hearts, and 5 of clubs on the flop, which I figure is a pretty good one for pocket fours. I decide to check. Caitlin checks after me, and Jesse c-bets for 2,000. Dave gets out of the way, and again, I have a ton of big blinds at this stage of the tournament, so I call. I want to see what he's working with. Caitlin gets out of the way as well, and Jesse and I see the 5 of hearts on the turn. I check once again, and Jesse slows down and checks back. And guess what? I just hopped into a boat on the river again. Dave smacks down the 4 of clubs, which I think's just too good to be true, but it gets better, because I lead for 6,375 chips, and he makes the call with the queen high flush.
Boom, ooh. Bam, ooh. Bop, bada bop, boom, pow. Oh!
He's got what? Oh, a flush?
I did. I was gonna hold
on the slow roll. What a dick.
First break, we have 92,275 chips. Wow. I look white in that lighting. Oh my god, my dad used to call me Casper. I really look like a ghost right now. That's crazy. All you need to know is that we're chip leader on break. Two people are out. I think there's 41 this year. So Tom would be out in 41st. He suffered a nasty 2-outer to Caitlin. He needed any card but a 9, and a 9 hit the river, which is great because he's a really good player. And then Rob, who won in 2021, is out. Break's only 6 minutes long. We're gonna get back in there. Coming back to 400, 800 blinds. We have 92,275 chips. Let's go. At the 400, 800 blind level, I limp in the cutoff after Dave limps in the hijack when it folds to us. Caitlin folds on the button. Lou, who's subbing for Jason W today, raises to 2,600 in the small blind. Doc gets out of the way in the big blind, and Dave, the original limper, folds as well. It's up to me, and I'm down to get into a heads up pot with my 9-6 suited. So I call, and we go to the flop. Caitlin deals the flop, and again, it's a pretty dreamy one. We flop middle pair and a flush draw. Interestingly, Lou checks, and I decide on a 1,000 chip bet. He quickly calls, and the jack of hearts hits the turn. We both quickly check, and the king of diamonds hits the river. I called Lou and asked him to sub today for Jason. He's a good player and full of surprises, so when he shoves on the river, I muck my cards and let him take the pot. Nice play. At 600-1200 blinds, I raised to 10,000 with pocket kings under the gun plus one, hoping for a call.
10 grand.
When Whenever I want some chips, I can always rely on Nick C to throw a few my way. He makes the call, and everyone else, including the players and the blinds, get out of the way. I'm just sitting here thinking I'll shove pretty much any flop because Nick doesn't have much left, and when Joe deals the 8-5-3 2-diamond flop, I just rip it in. Nick looks like he has a really tough decision, but then suddenly, he grabs his chip stack, lifts it up, and sends it into the pot.
What you got?
Bow! Jack. Bow! Do me a favor, please. Get out of here. Get out of here, man!
Right before dinner break, it folds to me in the small blind, and I look down at pocket fours. Hoping to bully my girlfriend's big blind, I shove it in, and she snap calls with ace king. Oops.
Classic for all
the chips.
I'm all right.
Oh. It looks like we shouldn't be messing with her. She's out for blood. It would have been super sick to not chop there, though.
Chop it up! Chop, 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 chop!
Just kick your shit back.
Yeah. That sure is a lot of food you got there.
Dinner break chip counts, week one.
I don't know. I don't count them. But hope I win.
133,000.
I have 112,500.
65,125. 63,525. 60,100. 58. 52,000. 50,000. About 50,000. 49. 45. 41. 36. 34. 3. 32. 33,000. 26,000. 25. 25. 24. 4. 24. 23. 4. 19. 18. 17. 9,000. Not enough. No chefs left.
See that belt. Real diamonds too this year. Nice.
A newcomer to the league, Dave. I guess we have another Dave. Just won a massive pot. Apparently it was 25K pre-flop, four ways, and he won. But yeah, I think we're in second place. See you after dinner.
DJ is vlogging.
Yup. Week one dinner. I guess Tony's surprising me with meals again. We have a seafood a la cinque. I'll put the menu item below. It's shrimp, scallops, clams, crab meat, and calamari in a seafood sauce made with fresh herbs and a touch of pimento, served over fettuccine. Let's try it out. Tony's sitting at my table, so I can't really do the food review at the table because I want it to be a surprise, so he watches my video because I need more people to watch my videos. Put a lot of work in these videos. I got a couple hundred people that watches them. I mean, this league, it's crazy. 40 people, 3 main event seats awarded. It's good content, I think. That's why I started vlogging this in the first place. Anyway, I digress. This seafood a la cinque, Tony came up to me and told me that it was gonna beat the salmon Italiano, which had a 9.72 from last year. It's very close. It's very close, but I don't want to satisfy Tony. We're gonna give it a 9.69, and we're looking forward to next week's dinner. Tony, thank you. 5 points. You the best. Appreciate the food. Let's get back to the tables. So I have a confession to make. I lost almost all my chips to Caitlin. My almost chip lead stack went straight down the gutter, and I feel terrible. So at 1,500, 3,000 blinds, I rip it in, get called by Caitlin once again, and Ricardo calls as well.
Good luck, sir.
Good luck.
Wow.
Ricardo calls.
Flip him up.
This is a huge triple up spot for me. Sometimes you have to go with your gut and take chances to be healthy again chip-wise in a tournament. I'm fine flipping here. If I lose, this will be my drop week for now, and if I win, we'll still have a chance to run this tournament over. Let's do this.
I'm just at sixes, that's
king. King, so.
Six.
King.
King nine, wow.
We got them all back. Let's freaking go, boys. 1,500, 3,000 blinds. Guaranteed 57 points if we get out now. Three tables left and they're pretty short, so we're gonna go down to two tables soon. At 1,500, 3,000 blinds, I raised a 10K under the gun with pocket nines. It folds around to Andrew on the button, who shoves for 6,800. Josh folds in the small blind, and Hector, a new member in the Vineland Poker League this year, makes the call. And we're off to a flop three ways with Andrew all in. Andrew deals the ace 7-7 flop. Hector checks, and I decide to check back, hoping to put a bet in on the turn if he checks again. The turn's the six of spades, and immediately, Hector shoves. Does he really have me beat here? Did he call my raise pre, check the flop when he paired his ace, and then he just shoves the turn? Well, shout out to Hector's cat. I have a good amount of chips at this point in time, and I don't think I should risk it by calling a 22K shove. So I end up making the fold. In hindsight, this was a great move by Hector, because when he shows his ace four of hearts and Andrew shows ace jack, the nine of hearts hits the river, which would have given me a boat.
Come on now, dawg. Come on, man.
Andrew wins the main pot. Hector wins the side pot, and I'm just sad. This is already a pretty long video, so let's fast forward to 12 people left and 3,000, 6,000 blinds. I have a pretty similar stack still, a little over 100,000. So at 3,000, 6,000 blinds, Kenny's under the gun, and he limps. Which is strange. So when Doc folds, we're up to our old ways of battling with Kenny. I look down at a suited king and raise to 22,500. Dave gets out of the way in the big blind. Andrew folds in the small blind. Matt folds in the big blind. And Kenny kisses the chips he limped in with goodbye. That's a sweet 18K bump to my stack. See you guys at the final table.
Final table chip counts. Week one.
210.
150.
137.
I have 114,500.
A little fun.
100, I think.
100.
A lot, not actually a lot, 80 maybe.
60.
35.5.
Not many.
With blinds at 4,000, 8,000, Matt shoves about 30K in middle position. Doc's next to act, and he seems to be in the tank, but after about a minute of thinking, he calls Matt's shove. It folds to me, and I look down at black pocket tens, and call Matt's shove as well. Medio, Bruce, and Steve get out of the way, and we go three ways to the flop with Matt all in. Medio deals the 2-3 ace 2-club flop, and Doc checks. I check back, and the 7 of spades hits the turn, and Doc quickly checks again. I check back, and a safe-looking 8 of hearts hits the river, and Doc checks quickly for a third time. I bet 10,000, and Doc quickly folds, showing his king-queen. Matt had king-high as well, and we take down a nice pot here. Goal one was to make the final table, but now that we're here, let's win this tournament. With blinds at 6,000, 12,000, I opened a 40,000 under the gun plus one, and it folds around to Kenny in the small blind. You know he's not going anywhere. He calls my huge raise, everyone else folds, and we're off to a flop in a 100K plus pot, and I only have Jack 9 off suit. The flop comes 10-6 Jack Rainbow, and when Kenny checks, I'm not giving this guy any free cards.
40.
Hey. He gets out of the way, and we have over 200,000 chips now in week one. Sick.
175K, halfway through 8,000, 16,000.
At 10K, 20K blinds, there's 4 of us left. And under the gun, Josh shoves it in for 142,000. I look down at Ace King and call his shove, creating a pot of over 300,000 chips. Josh shows King Queen, which is awesome, and my Ace King even has both his suits dominated, and I get to deal our fates. I deal the 2-7-4 all heart flop, which isn't optimal, especially when I put the 9 of hearts on the turn. I give the river a little peek before I put it on the table, and it's a black 8, giving me the win, a massive pot, and I have about a 500,000 chips now. Let's go. Only 2 more players to get through. Now it's down to 3 of us. Me, Steve, and Bruce. I've been steadily building my stack, and now I have half the chips in play. 650,000 at 15K, 30K blinds. And shortly after this, Steve is out in third, and it's down to me and Bruce.
We're still in the tournament. I talked to the only other person in the tournament, Bruce, into a 5-minute break. Just needed a breather. I think we have 6 minutes left in 15,000, 30,000 blinds. I have 620K, so we're pretty much dead even, playing for first place in week one. Hopefully the next clip you see will take it down. Let's go.
The hand that will live in infamy. At 15K, 30K blinds, Bruce limps in the small blind. I look down at a couple of face cards and raise to 100,000 chips, and he calls. Bruce deals the queen jack 8 flop, which gives me top 2 pair.
Two check.
Yep.
All in.
I call.
Wow. Wow.
Nice hand, Bruce.
It's cool. There's no getting around this. Hey.
How does that happen every time? It's not over.
Oh! Ew!
Dude!
What the fuck?
I'm not sure you guys realize this is the largest pot I've ever filmed. That was a 1.2 million chip pot. Almost 98% of the chips in this tournament. I'm left with one big blind and Bruce has more than 40. I've been heads up with Bobby H in 2022 and lost. I've been heads up with Andrew in 2023 and lost. Am I really gonna go 0 for 3 on the vlog heads up? It's gonna take a miracle now to win this tournament.
I'm all in.
And he's got a pair.
Got one left. Sunday, 3 games for you, 1 p.m. CBS. The winner of our game tonight will host the 7th seed in the AFC. 4:30.
Good game.
Fox.
3.
Get the Packers versus the Cowboys, and then 8 o'clock Lions. One game on Monday.
Good job.
When you raise it up to 100K total and flop top 2 on Queen Jack 8, and he just has 9-10. Can't win one of these on the vlog. It's all good though. Second place. Awesome finish for week 1. See you next time for week 2. Good game, Bruce. Thanks for watching, guys.
Today playing all night long. Are we ready for what's up ahead?